Hi, thank you for joining ArcherPoint today. We'll be covering word layouts in NAV 2016. This will work in NAV 2014 and up. So let's use sales orders as an example. So if we go to our sales order page and we print out a sales order to just look at how the current default report looks like, we can see that it's not exactly the best looking. So once it loads, we can see that it's not the most visually pleasing. And let's say we don't want to go into the dev and create a brand new report in the Visual Studio environment. So NAV actually provides an option where you can use Word to use templates in Word to make reports in NAV. So if we search for a sales order template, we can actually download that template and use that in NAV. So if we select this one, we can save it on our desktop and we can import it into NAV. And once we've saved it on the desktop, we can actually go into what's called Report Layout Selection in NAV. And this is where we can choose which report we want to modify or change completely. So we're going to search for sales order. And we can see that report 10075 is the sales order report that we want to customize. And so we choose here custom layouts. And we want to hit new custom layout. And we want to choose the insert word layout because that's what we'll be doing. We'll be inserting a word file. And this is where we can now import the layout from. So if we choose import, we can find our template for sales order template, and we can name it better template. Now we can edit the report and map the correct fields into this report. And it'll open up in Word. As you can see, this is the template we chose from Word, but none of the fields will map automatically. We'll have to go in there and do that. And to do that, you need this developer tab. Often the developer tab isn't shown. So to get that to show, we want to go into the options menu, and then we want to go to customize ribbon. And you'll see right here, this is often left unchecked. We want to go ahead and check that because that's what we'll be using to do all the mapping of the fields. So here we can go into XML pane, and that's where we'll be able to map the fields in. And we want to choose the sales order report 10075. And this is where all of the fields in the previous report were, and we can put it in the way we see fit. So we also need to go ahead and highlight all of these fields and remove the content control, because that allows us to type in the fields, but we want to actually just have it map in from the tables. So we don't want those content controls in there. So we can add the build to address using plain text. You just right click and choose insert content control, plain text, and this will map it in from the table. You want to just keep doing that, and we can also change the fields and the tables on the report itself. So let's say we don't want salesperson, we don't want job, we don't want shipping method or terms. We just want those three things. We can delete these columns and it'll move it over. And then let's say we want to insert a column to the left. We can go ahead and do that in design, in layout, and then we can do insert left. And we can say this is customer number. And we can go ahead and find which field maps over. So here it would be bill to customer number, and insert that in as plain text as well. So we'll just use this as an example, and we can also move on to lines. This is where things get a little bit more interesting. We want to delete all of the other lines except for the first one. So we go ahead, we can just do delete cells, and we want to highlight that first row. And if we scroll down, we'll see a sales line in the XML mapping pane. We want to right click on that and choose repeating. And now that we've selected that, we can go ahead and map in the fields within the sales line. So let's say quantity. We want to find temp line, sales line, quantity. And we can insert that in as plain text and do the same thing for the description is sales line. Description, and then we can do unit price, which is unit price to print, and we can just use this as an example. So we'll leave it at that. There's fields you'd want to fill out for everything, all the information you want on there. We can also insert logos in here. So as an example, I've copied an image, and I'm going to insert the ArcherPoint logo in here. So if I do that, we can see that it inserts perfectly, and we can go ahead and leave that in there. And it fits perfectly, looks nice. And you can also do it so that if you have your company information imported, you can choose the company picture, and that'll map in. But right now we're using Cronus, so it'll map in the Cronus picture. But this will have the ArcherPoint logo on all the sales order reports. So we can go ahead and save that and see how the report looks. So now it'll ask if we want to import the changes we just made, and we want to hit yes. And we can run this report to see how the changes mapped over and whether they mapped correctly. So we can see that we entered in the bill to address. We entered in the customer number. We didn't fill out any of this, so it didn't map over. We know that there's a quantity of 4, and it's this item for this price. So everything looks good here. We have the logo as well. So the next step, once you've mapped over all the fields, would be to actually change the selected layout on the report layout selection page. So we want to go ahead and use that drill down menu there and choose custom layout. And on this screen, we have to choose the custom layout we made. We can make multiple ones, and you can choose the one you like. And we can hit OK. And now nav will be using your custom layout for all sales orders reports that you'll be printing. So we can go ahead and test that. So let's just choose a random sales order, and we can hit print. And we can see that it has the information, the logo, everything that we put in there. So that's how you would do a word layout in NAV. Hope this helped. Thank you for joining ArcherPoint today.
Thanks for watching this ArcherPoint video. If you found it helpful, make sure to check out our website and blog at www.archerpoint.com. Additionally, if you have any questions regarding our products, services, or information in this video, feel free to email us at info@archerpoint.com. Thanks.